All right, now we will see another way of communication to get the values of sensors in the PLC in much more easier way, like I said before. So we have seen OPC UA before, and now I'm going to tell you that we have something called MQTT. Okay, this is a lightweight protocol for communication. So I'm going to use MQTT protocol to communicate between Raspberry Pi and PLC Next. So what's going to happen here? In MQTT, we have a broker. Okay, broker is which will get the values from the sensor. For example, here all the values are coming. Let's say we have a Raspberry Pi. So the Raspberry Pi has a broker inside. Inside, I will define this broker. And in this broker, this Raspberry Pi is basically, wait a second, sending the value. So it will publish the values in this broker. So we call it publish. And what it will publish? It will publish humidity, and it will also publish temperature. So broker will has these two values inside. Okay, now we have what we call subscribers. Subscriber or subscribers. In this case, PLC Next will be the subscriber. So over PLC Next will subscribe. Basically, what is happening? This will subscribe to these two values, okay? So this H and T, these are our topics. So it will subscribe to the topic H and to the topic T. So when it subscribes to this topic, it starts getting values of this H and T. So that's how it works. So in Raspberry Pi, we publish two topics, humidity and temperature, in a broker. And then you subscribe to this topic to get the values. So whosoever subscribe to the broker, it's called subscribers. So this, in this case, this is a PLC Next. It could be any other application or any other hardware which subscribes to the broker to get the values. So this is kind of easy way to send the small information. So I'm going to show you how does it work if it sounds complicated, but it's actually really easy. Okay, one more thing I want to mention here, that in this Raspberry Pi, we have Node-RED, which we use for publishing the topic. In PLC Next as well, we have Node-RED. If you're wondering how, so PLC Next, as I told you, has a Linux operating system inside, in which it is possible to install, it's possible to install Node-RED. It is possible. So you can find a lot of tutorials or documentation where you will see how to install Node-RED. But in my situation, I am actually using a Docker-based file. So I have a Docker system or a Docker inside my PLC Next. So PLC Next provides a Docker file which you can download from their server. And this Docker file, you have a container in which you can launch a Node-RED. So I find this is quite reliable, and it's more, what should I say? It was giving me less errors compared to when I was just installing Node-RED via Node.js environment and some steps. So if you try with Docker, maybe you will not find any errors. I was finding some errors with OPC when I was doing the other way. But if you try with Docker and how to do it with Docker, there is a link which I mentioned in the video. You can follow that with some steps, and you can install Node-RED in your PLC Next via Docker, and it's much more reliable. So once you launch Node-RED inside the Docker, you will find something like this. So this was my Raspberry Pi, which I showed you in the last video. That's my Node-RED. If you notice the IP address, that's the IP address of PLC Next. So this is a Node-RED running in PLC Next. This is the Node-RED running in Raspberry Pi. Notice the IP address, okay? So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna publish something. So if you notice here, we have a Mosca broker in Raspberry Pi, okay? Which has just MQTT port, which are default ports defined, okay? Now the value from humidity, I took a node and I defined this one here. This comes from MQTT out and I defined the topic humidity, okay? And if you notice the IP address, it's the local host. The local host of Raspberry Pi is the IP address of Raspberry Pi, okay? With the port of 183. This is important topic and the IP address. So this is defined as humidity and we need one more for temperature. So I will do it now. So let me just put it here. So you can see how it is defined. Topic I will write. Temperature. This is the same server. Click done and just connect it like this. So we have two topics, humidity and temperature. And now I will not write my OPC UA, so I will just delete these two nodes and deploy. So now OPC UA is getting nothing because I delete the nodes. So we have these two topics, humidity and temperature. Okay. Now what I will do is I will open my Node-RED. And I will go to my MQTT in, okay? I need two. One is for temperature, one is for humidity. So I will open this one. Server, I need a Raspberry Pi server. So if you open this, you notice I put the IP address of my Raspberry Pi, which is here, okay? You put this here as a server, port address is 1883. That's my server Raspberry Pi. And in the topic, I will write humidity. Click done. Here I will write temperature. And you click done. And you deploy. So you have humidity and temperature value coming. And if I want to visualize it, I can take a debug node. Deploy again. So you can see these two values are coming, 40.4. humidity and 25.2 temperature. Okay, so just by writing the topic, you are getting the value in your controller. And now you have the value in the Node-RED of PLC Next. You can do whatever you want with these values. If you just want to display, you can also display that. Or if you just want to put that into the variable, you can also do that. So I will show you both. So our PLC Next is here. This was the old values. So right now you can see it's 40.3. I will delete this. So the current value is 40.4, 25.2. So these are the old values. So if I want, I can just delete it. All right. So these are reset. Now we want to push these two values in my VLC. Now if you notice, this is a real. And here you're getting in string. So you can also convert from string to a number. So what you can do is, I will take a function and I will write message.payload is equivalent to number message.payload, this should work. Click done, I'll put it here. Debug here. And I put the same for temperature. And let's try. So now we have these two as a number, 40.4, 25.2. Perfect. Now I can use this. What I can do is I can just display it. Let's just display it. So I will go to my gauge. And this is going to be my humidity. That's my humidity and maximum, let's say it's 100%. Click done. And I will take another gauge. Let's name it as temperature. maximum is 100. Unit you can also define. In this case, I will take degrees Celsius. The humidity is in percentage. So I have these two values. Now if I want to open my dashboard in my PLC Next, I can see that here. So I have my temperature and I have my humidity coming in my Node-RED of PLC Next. Okay. So you can also visualize this dashboard. You can also visualize in your mobile phone or in another computer or any device in the same network. Okay. Now if you want to push this value in the PLC, like it's still not in the PLC. If you want to use it in the PLC, you can just do the same like OPC client. And in this case, this is my address of my PLC Next. Okay, I should do right. And now I have the number. I need to put the topic. So I can also do that here. I can also copy this from here, actually. This is the topic for humidity. And this one was for temperature, okay. Because the topic is same. This is humidity, correct. And temperature. Perfect. So these two values will go to the OPC UA as a write. And this is write, click done, click deploy. Now it is also started writing to your PLC. So if I open my PLC, in my UXpert, you can see the value. In the PLC, you can see the value. All right. So you can choose any of the way you like. If you're not doing much with the PLC, if you just want to display the value in your Node-RED dashboard, or you want to play around the value inside the Node-RED, then MQTT is the good way to do that. If you don't have Node-RED in your PLC Next, and if you want to move the value in your PLC, then you can write this OPC UA thing in your Raspberry Pi. So I have shown you both ways how to do that. Rest is up to you. So these are the two ways how these devices can communicate to each other. I hope you like this lesson. And if you find my videos interesting, just subscribe. I will be making more videos on different topics. And you can put a comment if you have any doubts. So thank you for watching, and I wish you a nice day.